Sydney, Lester, and my fellow team members, today on 8th of November 2020, we are giving our presentation as a part of our assignment of compiler design given by our SRC. Our two phases of compilers will be delivered by Apurva Pradhan, Debuma Banerjee, and myself, Debavati Odhikari. Let's begin. At first, we have to know, in computing, compiler is a computer program that translates computer code written in one programming language, that is the source language, into another language, that is the target language. The name compiler is primarily used for programs that translate source code from a high-level programming language to a low-level language, that is assembly language, object code, machine code, to create an executable program. Now, types of compiler. There are three types of compiler: native compiler, and source-to-source compiler. Native compiler is a compiler that works on compilation of the same technology on which it runs. It uses the same operating system platform as the software which it is assembling machine language. Next, the cross compiler that runs on a machine A and produces a code for another machine B. It is capable of creating code on a platform other than the one on which the compiler is running. And the third one, source-to-source compiler, or transcompiler or transpiler, is a compiler that translates source code written in one programming language into source code of another programming language. Now, we'll discuss about the phases of compiler. There are two major phases of compiler. The first one is analysis phase, and the second one is synthesis phase. The analysis phase is divided in four steps: lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, and intermediate code generator. And the second one, synthesis phase, is divided in two steps: code optimizer and code generator. Next, we will discuss symbol table. Symbol table is an important data structure being used and maintained by the compiler. Consists all the identifiers name along with their types. It helps the compiler to function smoothly by finding the identifiers quickly. It is used by all the phases of compiler as follows. In lexical analyzer, it creates new table entries in the table, like entries about token. Syntax analysis. It adds information regarding attribute type, scope, dimension, line of reference, use, etc. in the table. Semantic analysis. It uses available information in the table to check for semantics, that is to verify that expressions and assignments are semantically correct and update it accordingly. Intermediate code generation. It refers symbol tables for knowing how much and what type of runtime is allocated, and tables helps in adding temporary variable information. Code optimization. Uses information present in same table for machine-dependent optimization. And the last one, target code generation. It generates code by using address information of identifier present in the table. That's all. Now I would hand over to Apurva to explain the types of analysis and onwards.
Thank you, Devaruti. So this is Apurva. I am going to discuss the types of analysis. The analysis of source program is divided into three phases. there are linear analysis, hierarchical analysis, and semantic analysis. The linear analysis involves a scanning phase where the stream of character are read from left to right. It is then grouped into various tokens and having a collective meaning. In hierarchical analysis, the analysis phase based on collective meaning, and the tokens are categorically into nested groups. In semantic analysis, this phase is used to check whether the components of source program are meaningful or not. Next, coming to the first phase of compiler, this is the that is lexical analyzer. It is also called scanner. It takes the output of preprocessor, which performs file inclusion or macro expansion as the input, which in pure high-level language, it reads the character from source program and groups them into lexeme. Each lexeme corresponds to a token. Tokens are defined by regular expression, which are understood by the lexical analyzer. It also removes lexical errors, example comments or white spaces, etc. Next. Then coming to the next phase, that is syntax analysis. It sometimes called as parser. It constructs the parse tree. It takes all the tokens one by one and uses context-free grammar to construct the parse tree. The parse tree is also called derivation tree. The parse tree can be compressed to form a syntax tree. Syntax error can be detected at this level. So there is a diagram below. Lexical analyzer, then token, then coming to the syntax analyzer, then the process is going to the token stream, and then the diagram is maintained by the context-free grammar. Next. Next, here is the expression sum plus sum multiply r. So here sum is the identifier token, plus is the operator token, multiply is the operator token, and r is the identifier token. And this is the syntax tree. We call it as syntax tree, id, identifier, multiply, identifier, then the multiplication will add it with the another identifier. The next slide will be explained by Debomoy Banerjee.
Thank you, Apurva. So the next phase of the analysis phase is semantic analysis. The semantic analysis checks whether the parse tree constructed follows the rules of language. For example, assignment of values is between compatible data types and adding string to an integer. Also, the semantic analyzer keeps track of identifiers, their types and expressions. Whether identifiers are declared before use or not, the semantic analyzer produces an annotated syntax tree as an output. The next phase of the analysis phase is the intermediate code generator. After semantic analysis, the compiler generates an intermediate code of the source code for the target machine. It represents a program for some abstract machine. It is in between the high-level language and the machine language. The intermediate code should be generated in such a way that it makes it easier to be translated into the target machine code. Coming to the next phase of the synthesis is the code optimization. The next phase does the code optimization of the intermediate code. Optimization can be assumed as something that removes unnecessary code lines and arranges the sequence of statements in order to speed up the program execution without wasting resources such as CPU and memory. And the last phase of the synthesis analysis is the code generation. In this phase, the code generator takes the optimized representation of the intermediate code and maps it to the target machine language. The code generator translates the intermediate code into a sequence of relocatable machine code. Sequence of instruction of machine code performs the task as the intermediate code would do. Now, coming to the old gate level questions, the first question now is the source code optimizations are carried out on the intermediate code because the first option is they enhance the probability of the compiler to the other target processors. The second option is program analysis is more accurate on intermediate code than on machine code. The C option is the information from data flow analysis cannot otherwise be used for optimization. And the last option is the information from the front end cannot otherwise be used for optimization. So the first answer is the correct, that is they enhance the probability of the compiler to the other target processors. Because the main purpose of doing some code optimization on intermediate code generation is to enhance the probability of the compiler to target processors. So option A is more suitable here. Now taking the next slide to Apurva.
So thank you, Devamoy. There are three statements. We have to choose which one is the correct or wrong. Yeah, which statement is the correct? The first statement is symbol table is accessed only during lexical analysis or syntax analysis. The second one is compilers for programming language that support recursion necessarily need heap storage for memory allocation in the runtime environment. The third one, errors violating the any variable must be declared before its use are detected during syntax analysis. So there are four options. The first statement is true, the first or third, or none of the above. The correct answer is D. Next. So let's go to the explanation. The first statement is false because symbol table by all six phases of compiler. Lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic, intermediate code, and code optimization and target code generation. The next statement is false because heap allocation is used to dynamically allocate memory to the variables. Heap allocation can be used in before its use must be done by semantic analysis. So the option D is appropriate, is correct. The next slide will be explained by Devaruti.
Thank you, Apurva. The question number 3 is, which data structure in a compiler is used for managing information about variables and their attributes? Option A, as syntax tree. Option B, symbol table. Option C, semantic stack. And option D, parse table. Here, the option B, symbol table, is correct. Because symbol table is a data structure which is used by a language translator, compiler, or interpreter where each identified program source code is associated with information relating to its declaration or appearance in the source, such as its type, scope level, etc. So that's all about our presentation. Thank you, Asati sir, for giving us this opportunity, and also thanks to my team members.
Thank you, Devamoy, Apurva, Devaruti. Very good presentation. Thank you.